exosomes are produced by our cells, and they're important for cell-to-cell communication, as well as delivering cargo between one cell type and another. And the way that they're made is they're actually first produced within our cells in something called an endosome, which holds on to these vesicles. Then that endosome will fuse with the cell membrane, releasing those vesicles into the extracellular space. And that's where the term exosome comes into play, as now they've left the cell. And if we zoom in on what these exosomes actually look like, you can almost think of them like a really small cell. They're composed of a lipid bilayer, and they have proteins on the outside of that exosome that helps direct it exactly where it needs to go within the body as it travels through the bloodstream. Additionally, it's loaded with DNA, RNA, or even proteins that were made from the cell that it originated from. But can we use exosomes as a delivery system for pharmaceuticals? Well, the answer is yes, because exosomes can actually be engineered to have specific proteins on the outside of the exosome to direct it exactly where it needs to go within the body, so cell or tissue type specific. Additionally, it can be loaded with all different types of pharmaceuticals. These include small molecules, mRNA, or even proteins or monoclonal antibodies, which can be difficult in order to get to the cell of interest. And a benefit of these exosomes is it allows for controlled drug release, so releasing that drug as it's needed, and it extends the half-life of the drug because it protects that drug before it has a chance to be metabolized by the body, ensuring that it gets to the destination of interest.